All right, so in this video, I'm gonna take all the code we wrote to get the last row, and I'm gonna convert it to last column instead of being last row. So how do we find the last column in our data instead of finding the last row? And I'm not gonna go in detail about these lines and what they mean. If you want to understand that, you should watch the first video before this one, the one where I show how to find the last row. But in this one, I'm just gonna go to this data, I guess, and we'll get started. So the first method will do control right to get to the right end of this data. And that would be, I'm just gonna change this to control right. And then I'll say LC now instead of LR. Comment this line for last row. So to find the last column, we're gonna go to A1 cell first, which is that left corner here. And from that, we're gonna do Excel to right. So be careful, it's not Excel right, it's Excel to right. And this time we're gonna get the column, not the row. So now if I run this code, see we get 6, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's our first method. Let's move to the next one, last column. For this one, instead of doing control right from A1 cell, we're gonna go to the last column and do control left to get to the first column with some data in it. So again, that's gonna be in the first row, and we're gonna go in the first row, the last column in our spreadsheet. So we'll just do cells, and we need to be in the first row, and the last column we'll do columns.count to get the last column in the spreadsheet, and then we'll do Excel to left instead of Excel to right, and then instead of dot row we'll get dot column to get the column number. So again, if I run this code, it should give us 6. And again, I'm not gonna talk about advantages or disadvantages. If you want to understand those, watch the first video for rows. The next one is finding, using that find method to find the last column. That is gonna be this last column. So we're gonna do find. And the only thing we really need to change here is instead of doing search by rows, I guess if we do Excel by columns and search by columns and get the column number. So that should get us to what we need. So now if we're going by columns like this, right? We're gonna go this way with our search instead of by rows where we go like this way. If we go by columns, and we start in the cell, but then we do previous, that means we're gonna go from the other end, and we're gonna go from like this columns and search, 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 search until we find the first column with some data in it. Then we're gonna hit that and we're gonna get the last column. So if you want to find the last column and there is no row you can trust, this should be a good method to go about this. Let's just run this. See, we get 6 again. Now, if I go to this one, which is a little more messier here, let's say I don't have this category here too. If we run this, see, we get 5. So that should get us this, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So that's that. Now, again, this is the same thing with numbers instead of these. So this is the same, this is the same. This part that says Excel by columns, so that would be not this one, not this one, which is the partial here. It would be this one, and I guess should be the second one, if I'm not mistaken. And the rest should be the same, with exception that row will change to column. So let's just run this and make sure we get what we should. Looks good. So this is the same as this one, only with numbers replaced instead of this enumeration right here. Now let's get to the region. if we do that whole control A thing, the last column based on this, we can do this, go from A1 cell, do control A, and then instead of rows.count, we'll do columns.count to figure out how many columns we have. And if we run this, let me just click on some random cell here first. That gives us 5. That's the number of columns we have in the selection. Now, let's say your data is more like this, and you need to find the last column in this case, which should be G. So we first have to get to this and then get the last column. So how do we do that? So first, let's get the number of blank columns on left. So I'm just going to call it ALC. So this message box prints it out. So again, the way we can do that, we can go to this A2 cell, which is the second row, first column, 2, 1. And then instead of going control down, we can do Excel to right. And that's going to do control right. And then current region is going to, basically, we're going to go here, control right, control A, select all of this. And with that, we're going to find the column number, which is the first column with some data in it. And then -1 would be the number of blank rows. So this should return 2 because, well, that's 2 blank rows. If I do this, that should give me 3. And if I delete all of those, and then we do this, 0. That's good. The number of blank rows. I'm gonna get rid of this part. And I'm going to add those blank rows back. So now we're just going to convert this row line we did before to a column. So the last column, if we use this method, again, we're going to start from the second row, first column. We're going to do control right, which is Excel to right. And then we're going to select the current region. We're going to get the column and then -1. Because we want the number of blank columns. So this will be the number of blank columns plus. We again will take second row and first column, do control right, current region. And then instead of doing rows.count, we'll do columns.count to count the number of columns. So now if we just run, let me make this bigger a little bit. Still doesn't fit. I'm gonna just move this to the next line. Here we go. So again, underscore, if you remember, I've mentioned this already, that's a way for us to write something on the next line and have it be treated as being on the same line as above. So now if I run this code, it gives me 7. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. That is correct. And if I delete these, it should be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So let's just run this as well. There it is, 5. And that's it. So that's a bunch of different ways for us to get the last column. Again, if you want to understand the difference between these different methods and which one you should use in which case, I suggest you watch the first video where I show how to find the row number. But for this one, that should be it. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.